Greetings, everyone. 2K Sports brings you the NBA. This is Kevin Harlan. I'm joined by Clark Kellogg and Steve Kerr as we get set to bring you all the action. And now a quick check of our starting lineups for both teams. Okay, first for the Bulls. Harper's out there with Michael Jordan. We've got Longley. They'll be watching him boxing out and maneuvering for the easy baskets inside. They'll be counting certainly on his production. Then there's Pippen, and it's Rodman in at the four. And looking at Utah, John Stockton out there with Jeff Hornacek. We've got Foster. He'll be battling over the boards to get the job done, both on offense and defense. Then it's Keith, and it's Malone in at the four spot. And it's going to be the Bulls off the tip. Harper against Stockton. Shot from 12. And it's blocked by Malone. Chicago on defense. Hornacek passes to Stockton. Up top, Malone. And a foul on the shot. He'll go to the strike for two.
Some of the quickest hands in the league on him, guys. And we see it in how often he's able to poke a ball loose just as his man is going up for the shot.
Steve, another signature part of his game is the way he runs the pick and roll. He gets so many easy baskets that way. It's a play they should run for him as often as they can.
And both free throws good for Malone. Now Harper. The drive by Jordan. The feather touch on the finger roll. Beautiful.
You know, something we're seeing less and less of these days, that little finger roll.
And it's Utah's ball. And let's get this update now from Doris Burke, who's across the way on the sideline.
Well, Kevin, the head coach for the Jazz gave me just a couple of moments to catch up with him. He said that he and the assistants really carefully picked over the game plan, going up against a top-tier defense. I asked him their plan of attack, and he told me that he didn't want to get into specifics, but that we could trust that they'd give their best scorers ample opportunity to get their shots, and that he expected motion and hustle from their role players. Kevin, back to you.
Thanks a lot, Doris. And dealing with the sort of defense they're facing is not an easy challenge.
No, but they've got a few weapons of their own that they can counter with, so it's not exactly a one-sided battle.
Maybe so, Steve, but those weapons are still going to have to perform at a really high level for them to have a chance to be successful. He got a great read of where that miss was going, and that allowed him to be the first guy to it and get the putback.
Right side, Jordan. And good on the basket. Hook it.
Good defense, but you gotta love the finish with the finger roll over the top.
First 1:30 gone here in the first quarter. So it's Utah now. Stockton outside. Stockton left side. And the rejection by Pippen. Jordan kicks to Harper. Rodman. It's blocked. And so it looks like the Bulls will retain possession here. Harper kicks to Pippen. Unloads. With one on the clock, and there's Michael Jordan, the assist by Pippen. 6 points for Michael Jordan. At the end of one, a closely contested game so far. It's the Bulls. They lead by two. After this break, we'll be back with the start of the second quarter on 2K Sports. And so far, it's been a closely contested game as we get the second quarter up and going. And taking a look at Chicago's performance here, Clark and Steve, what have they been doing or not doing?
And I thought the defense was key here for this club. They really tightened up and made it difficult on their opponent.
How about the help on the drives and rotations? I mean, they've really been in sync as a unit.
Opponent's not going. And they forced the miss with that good defensive rotation. They're playing well together as a unit.
So he gets the whistle. Contact on the way up and two shots coming up. Bulls shooting their first free throws of the game. And he makes the first. Antoine Carr, he's checked in for Karl Malone. He doesn't get the second one. Deflects the pass. Bulls on D. It's a three-point game. Here's Isley. Dishes to Hornacek. Smooth as silk on the finger roll. One 16 left to play here in the second quarter. Rodman with a screen on Hornacek. Here's Jordan. Utah with the rebound.
Well, with that much space off the pick, you've got to drop that in.
Yeah, you got to make that one. I mean, that's a high-quality shot you should make 9 out of 10 times.
Heisler. And they're going to count the bucket and send him to the line. It could be a three-point play.
Well, sometimes when you're at a height disadvantage, that's the way to attack. Go right at your defender.
The Jazz shooting their third free throw attempt for the game. We play just over a minute of basketball here in the second quarter. Pippen against Anderson from 12 feet out. Outside Jordan. Passed a long way. Back to Jordan. Laid in with a nice touch off the glass. Jordan's got 8.
Well, he's so good at recognizing where the openings are and getting the ball to the rim. Definitely a 2-for-1 situation here, guys.
Yeah, the wise move would be to find themselves a quick shot right away.
Rodman against Carr, doubled by Harper. Carr, the pass to Anderson. 6 to shoot. On deep. It's rebounded by Harper.
Not the best shot. Long range and with a defender right in his face.
Oh! Are you kidding me? That was a power punch right there.
Oh, great.
Man, he got fancy with that one, didn't he?
Yeah, maybe trying to give them the momentum boost they need to break this game open.
Man, I like that. I mean, some coaches might want to see just a sure-handed lay-in, but I say put as much as you can on the finish and get your teammates going.
And it's going to be out of bounds. The Bulls will take it.
Boy, did they ever make a mess out of that one. A terrible turnover.
Here's Longley. Screen by Longley. The drive by Jordan. Can't cash in on the 10-foot jumper. And a tight game here as we end the first half. Bulls lead by 2. And we'll be back for the second half following the break. Keep it right here on 2K Sports.
Now, presented by Sprint.
This is Damon Bruce, ready to bring you the halftime report on 2K Sports. Let's go! Chicago with the lead against Utah. Their great passing has been fun to watch, keeping the ball moving and picking apart that D. The game's top scorer, Michael Jordan. After 2, he's got 10 points and has helped out a bit on the boards as well. But the Jazz getting after it as well. We've seen all these blocks and they are locked in defensively, giving up no easy buckets. Their top scorer is the mailman, Karl Malone. He's picked up 4 points and, as usual, is sending away a lot of shots early on. And that does it for us here in the studio. Thanks so much for joining me. And now, back out to Kevin and the gang.
The Sprint Halftime Report, presented by Sprint.
Welcome back, everyone. The second half about to get underway, and it's been a close one so far. We've seen Michael Jordan really having a great game.
He is a dynamic scorer, guys. That much we know. And I'll tell you what, his talent was on full display there in the first half.
Steve, he is a hard man to keep down, and so far, they've been unable to do it.
Pass to Hornacek. Foster is screen on Jordan. Back to Stockton. For the three. The rebound by Jordan. Chicago leading. And here we go. The Bulls. Fast break. Pippen. No stopping him there. Jams it in as he's fouled. Chance now for a three-point play. They get John Stockton.
Boy, great job of attacking on the break.
Yeah, sure was. He made a beeline for the bucket as soon as they got the ball. Right away, straight to the rim.
The Bulls have shot two free throws and they're 1-2 so far. Here's Hornacek. We've got 1:28 left to play in the third. Kicks it to Stockton. Foster is screen on Harper. And Stockton, here we go. Stockton can't get that one to fall.
Well, he was right there, but the defensive pressure forced that miss. Well contested.
Really made it a tough shot.
An indication there of why the scoreboard looks like it does. Very passive defense.
But the finish was anything but passive.
No, he hammered that down, Clark. Superb above the rim action.
Hornacek dishes to Stockton. Right, 54 seconds left to play in the third. That's blocked. Jordan against Keith. And there's Michael Jordan, the assist from Rodman. 14 points for Michael.
These defenders are not putting up much of a fight on the interior. It's been embarrassing. That's 10 consecutive points allowed in the lane.
And that's not the kind of streak you want to have if you're playing defense.
Pippen against Malone. Stockton. To help the run. And it's good on the way. Third quarter of basketball, about a minute and a half in. Harper kicks to Jordan. Uses the glass to finish the layup. Jordan's got 16.
You know, they've been so effective when they've been able to get the ball inside.
Some real shortcomings from this defense. I mean, they've given up five straight looks in the paint.
Stockton against Harper. Malone drives in. Pippen with the steal. And here we go. The Bulls. Fast break. Leads him in there. They get the rebound. Here's Harper. And that one's drained from the low block. And as we end the third quarter, a double-digit deficit will make it tough to come back. It's Chicago up by 11. And time to step aside quickly, but we'll be back in no time with the start of the fourth quarter. Welcome back. Fourth quarter action starting up in what has been a one-sided show. Chicago leading by 11. He dishes it to Jordan. Left side, Jordan. Rodman passes to Jordan. Pippen. But they'll get another chance. Rodman kicks to Jordan. Not enough on that one as it misses. For the Jazz, this one's not looking good. It's tipped and stolen by Jordan. Pippen dishes to Jordan.
Oh, my goodness. What a huge play. And with that basket, you'd have to think this lead is safe.
Well, if not 100% safe, certainly 95%.
.119 left in the fourth. Hornacek kicks to Stockton. Back to Hornacek. Now the pass to Malone. Knocks it loose. And it's going to be out of bounds. The Bulls will take it.
Well, I think that pass caught him off guard, but he showed us board hands, too.
Rodman with the ball. In low to Longley. Outside for Jordan. And some nice ball movement here by Chicago. That one wide left.
You just assume he's going to knock those down when he's as open as he was there.
And Stockton, here we go. Here's Ostertag, and he converts the layup.
Guys, he's actually indefatigable. He never gives in, never gives up on a play, and that's what it takes to be a great offensive rebounder. You've got to be relentless.
And Jordan gets it to go.
Well, you relish these sorts of road games where you come in and you get the job done.
And a long schedule with the kinds of pressure of travel and tough opponents throughout the season, it's always good when you play a game like they have here.
Doris Burke has an update for us. Doris?
Yeah, during that break, the head coach of the Jazz had some words for his team. He said, listen, we've come this far. Now we've got to lay it on the line to get a win. I know we can do it. So show them what you got and let's make it happen. Guys, we'll see if they can do it.
Six on the shot clock. Here's Isley. The finger roll finish at the bucket.
Looks like they're going to finish strong, but just aren't enough ticks left on the clock.
Well, Steve, it's a good run they're having now, but they just waited too long to have it.
We've got 13 seconds left in the fourth quarter. Here's Jordan. That falls. Nice feed that time from Scottie Pippen.
Just look at how quickly their lead has grown over the course of the last few possessions.
Boy, they've really saved their best for last, haven't they?
Anderson with the ball. And out of bounds as the Bulls gain possession.
Just got a little careless on that pass. They should be able to connect on those.
5 seconds left here in the fourth quarter. Shoots it up. Misses the shot. And so Chicago takes this one, and by a big margin. They put on a show tonight, thoroughly controlling each end of the floor.
Hey, what more can you ask?
And that'll do it for Clark Kellogg, Steve Kerr, and Doris Burke. This is Kevin Harlan. Thanks for watching this presentation of the NBA on 2K Sports. And now we present the Jordan Player of the Game, Michael Jordan.